Hey guys, B-Gamer here. How's everybody doing today? We're back with part 3 of Call of Cthulhu, Dark Corners of the Earth. And we're gonna find out what's going on in Innsmouth. Alright. Supposed to be doing. Having a mission, apparently.
I'm looking for Brian Burnham.
Can't say as I noticed what you're saying, stranger.
Maybe this guy has something new to say now. Got Lady to talk to us.
Where did you say Waite's house was again?
I think it's over on Dock Street, near the back of the poorhouse.
And I have the keys to the poorhouse. What's she doing here?
Jack, we can't be seen talking together. What is it?
Why do you stay in Innsmouth, Rebecca?
My grandfather, John Lawrence, was editor of the Innsmouth Courier. He was murdered in the slaughter of 46. He had always despised the Marshes and their blasphemous doings. And it was he who led the party out to the reef that night. They arrested Captain Marsh and his order and tossed them in the old jailhouse. A few weeks later, my grandfather was dead. My father saw him die. Him and many others burned alive in the courier's basement.
All the more grounds to leave.
To leave would be to fail my own legacy. I have a duty to protect the good in Innsmouth. At least what little good remains.
Sure
she knows
to
plenty,
house.
But I need to have a look around myself if I'm gonna crack this case.
Really wish I could run.
It's unlocked.
And we're loading.
If I see you without fire, I'll report your order.
I'll not say nothing.
Man, that guy needs to, back off.
I'm looking for Brian Burnham.
Just leave me be, stranger.
Yeah, I'm gonna talk to this dude.
Do you know the Burnham lad? He worked in the First National.
Can't say I noticed what you're saying, stranger.
The hell?
Do you need any help? Disease is rampant in this town. Do you need any help?
Guess he doesn't need any help. Yep, I guess it's not a door that can be opened.
This town's deserted. Where is everybody?
If you don't like it, just turn around and leave.
What are you looking at, dude?
It's the entrance to the town poorhouse.
All Something's stalking me.
Since old Lady Warren's passed away, the food is rotten, but we'll die soon enough.
What are you looking at there, old-timer?
Nothing. I'm just looking. What you doing in old Warren's house, young feller? This hole is for the broke and the dying.
I'm trying to find Dock Street.
It's out back of the house. Everything in Innsmouth is rotten and dying. Windows boarded up, and all sorts of curious barking and crawling around black cellars and attics. How'd you like to be living in a town like this, feller?
I've been to more welcoming places. I don't think he's been outdoors for years. He isn't gonna know anything.
He knew where Dock Street was.
This almshouse is home to the old and the destitute.
Why did you say that when I clicked on a person?
The old woman's dead.
Lovely.
It won't budge.
I'm not walking on those boards. You think I'm stupid? I'm getting dizzy. Is that Dock Street? The ladder mechanic is a little weird. Oh, guess I'm dropping down. That was a long way to trip.
Won't budge. It won't budge.
Well, why won't it? What you looking at, lady?
I'm looking for Brian Burnham.
Can't see as I notice what you're saying, stranger.
Try getting the crap out of your ears and listening. Seriously? Yeah, that was terrifying. Oh, come on, let me jump it. Please? Can I crouch jump? Apparently I can't jump while crouching.
Jesus, those people have been ripped apart.
Indeed they have, Jack. Yeah, this must be the house.
Hello there, little lady.
Hi, sir.
Are your parents at home?
Daddy's at work, and Mommy's upstairs in the attic. She's been bad.
I see. So, what's your name, little lady?
Ramona.
Well, Ramona, could you get your mommy for me?
Nope. Mommy bites. Daddy says we've got to keep her up there for her own good.
Excuse me?
When I go near the door, she growls. I don't love Mommy like I love my daddy.
You don't say. Ramona, I really need to speak to your daddy. Do you know when he'll be home?
Soon, I think. You can wait inside if you like. Daddy won't mind. I'm drawing pictures with my crayons.
That would be great. Thanks. I should check the place over while I've got the chance.
Yeah.
What are you drawing, Ramona?
Pictures of Mommy and Daddy.
What are you drawing, Ramona?
Pictures of Mommy and Daddy.
Am I trying to get her to let us see the pictures?
It won't budge. An old chest of drawers. Nothing of interest.
Which
won't budge. It's a recent family photo. The corner's been torn off. I can only see Thomas and Ramona Waits in the picture.
That made me jump. I'm trying to figure out which door is the attic, so I opened it last. Oh, probably the bolted one.
It won't budge. It won't open.
Of course it won't. No, I can't save. Mrs. Wait. Hello? Ah! Ooh, that's loose. Oh, crap. That also wasn't human. Oh, no. Sorry, little girl. Get up, dude!
Looks like a diary.
Don't really want to go explain to him why his daughter's dead. So we'll just we'll read a diary. That's what we'll do. Oh, and this. Innsmouth robbery. Missing manager accused. In yesterday's edition, we reported on a burglary at the recently opened First National grocery store in Innsmouth. The case took a new turn today as authorities in the town named Brian Burnham, the store's manager, as a suspect in the case. Burnham has not been seen since the robbery and is thought to have left the area. That's what they want us to think, anyway. It is a very straightforward case, said Chief Constable Andrew Martin in response to inquiries by the advisor. This young man simply robbed his employer and fled. I imagine he's out of the county now, if not the state. The Chief Constable dismissed concerns expressed by First National Grocery's Regional Manager, Mr. Arthur Anderson, that Burnham may have been kidnapped or injured. That's because he has been kidnapped or injured. By the Chief Constable. Probably. The last entry in the diary is from today. It reads, another sleepless night. I lay awake, listening to the movements of that thing that I married, pacing about her locked room. Damn the esoteric order of Dagon. Damn the oaths. And damn the town fathers for not hanging Obed Marsh when they had the chance. No, burning him. Him and his whole filthy clan. I wish I could just leave. Abandon my shame. Sham of a life. Sham of a marriage. Leave the store to rot and start a new life far, far away. But I'm trapped here. Every time I look at Ramona, I know it. Watching her sleep and her beauty and innocence, my heart feels like breaking. She has no idea of what she will become. Might be for the best that she's dead. Yesterday was her 10th birthday. The change cannot be far off. Her birth gave me such joy, so much that I still use the month, day, and year as the four-number combination for my safe. In that order, starting clockwise. When's her birthday? Did I need to find that out from her before she got killed? It is as though I am trying to preserve the date forever and deny the inevitable horror. Sometimes I think of killing her, an act of mercy before she starts to manifest the horror. God forgive me, but she is my daughter and I could never harm her. She is blameless in all this. When the time comes, Innsmouth will be the only place for her, and until then, I must stay here to watch over her. This is my penance, my atonement for cheating her life with her chosen mother, after she joins them. If the grief does not kill me, my life will be my own once more. Not that I know how I will have the strength to go on without her. But when's her birthday? Did she say today was her birthday? And what is today? I think I'm gonna have a problem in a little bit. Hey, do I have...
It won't open.
Excuse me. I'm trying to see if I can use a first aid kit.
Oh, God. No.
They've taken the last thing I loved away from me.
I'm sorry. I didn't realize what was up there. What the hell was that thing?
There's no time to explain. They'll be here soon. Listen to me closely. You've been the talk of the town all day, asking after the Burnham lad. I heard he never made it to Boston, that he was copped by the Order of Dagon.
Did he pocket anything from the store's safe?
Thankfully, no. It's sturdy. He'd never have wrenched it open with a crowbar. There's something in there that needs protecting from the Order. You've got to get it out of Innsmouth. Take the key to the back of my store. The safe combination's in my diary, upstairs. Hurry, Jack!
What the hell's in the safe, anyway?
You've gone too far this time, Wait. We're taking you in for murder. You'll swing for this.
Wait, he didn't do anything wrong.
He killed his own daughter, and down flesh and blood. There's plenty wrong with that. I'm reckoning you do well to mind your own business, stranger. In Innsmouth, we handle things by the old ways.
Like making up false charges.
It won't open. It won't open. It's Ramona's coloring book.
Maybe her birthday is
It won't
there.
Open.
It'd be crazy for them to expect you to just make that... keep on date and stuff like that. Drawings to fill Ramona's book are like things from a nightmare. It's hard to believe that a young child could imagine such horrors. She's probably not imagining them. There are pictures of strange, unnatural creatures, crudely drawn, but still able to provoke visceral feelings of revulsion. One of them is captioned with the word mother. What can it mean? These profoundly disturbing images raise grave concerns about the girl's state of mind. But when's her birthday? Did I miss something in here?
Thank you.
Jack, Jack. Oh, thank God I found you. Wait's been arrested for the murder of his daughter.
I know.
I was there.
It's my fault, Rebecca.
What are you talking about, Jack? What's your fault?
There was something in the attic. Some kind of animal, and I let it loose. It's all my fault. The police dragged Waits off. He can't take the fall for this. He's done nothing wrong. We gotta do something.
Guilty or not, the Order will see him lynched for it. There's nothing you can do. Oh, you must have taken quite a bang in there, Jack. Your head's bleeding.
Yeah, I think I was out of it for a little while.
I see you've got some bandages. Use them on your head. It'll help you heal. You're not losing too much blood. You won't need a suture.
Thanks, Rebecca. Before they could drag him off, Tom Waits gave me the key to the variety store.
If you're going to snoop around in there, be careful. It's just off the main square. There's a back way down a flight of stairs.
He told me to protect whatever's in the safe, to get it out of town.
You got nothing to say about
Rebecca,
that?
Rebecca, I saw the oddest tramp, just by the poorhouse. He wore old shawls over his head, but jeez, the skin on his arms and hands were, I don't know, tainted in some way.
The poor wretch. It's the Innsmouth curse, and probably the latter stages of it.
This curse, plague, or whatever you call it, is it some form of leprosy?
I fear not. Lepers at least have the salvation of death upon them.
Before they could drag him off, Tom Waits gave me the key to the variety store.
If you're going to snoop around in there, be careful.
It's
just off the main square. There's a back way down a flight of stairs.
He told me to protect whatever's in the safe, to get it out of town.
Alright, well, let's see if I can bandage now. Now I click on me.
Before they could drag him off, Tom Waits gave me the key to the variety store.
If you're going to snoop around in there, be careful. It's just off the main square. There's a back way down a flight of stairs.
He told me to protect whatever's in the safe, to get it out of town.
I was hoping it would, he would ask her if he knew the girl's birthday. Suffer a sanity loss, you risk developing a mental condition. Good. Sanity. Yet these games, sorry, this hasn't been real action-y. These games are more about the character being slowly driven insane rather than just straight face-to-face fighting monsters.
It's unlocked.
It's unlocked.
Won't budge.
The hell?
You don't look like your standard crook, sweetheart.
Jesus, you crazy sap! Who the hell are you?
Jack Walters, private detective.
I'm wondering the same
and considering
thing.
Your recent breaking and entering, how about I ask the questions?
Have you any idea who I am?
No?
Nope.
And I really don't care.
My family has influential contacts in the Order, so I'd advise you to mind your manners, sir.
I'm from out of town. The Order doesn't hold much sway with me.
Really? Out of town, you say? How interesting. I'm Ruth. Ruth Billingham.
Huh. You're Brian's broad. That figures.
Brian? I don't believe I know a Brian.
Yeah, right.
What?
I've been fed that line 1,000 times, and for much better liars than you. Look, Ruth, the rumor around town is that your lover boy is in the hands of the Order.
What? No, that's not true. They'll have him killed. It was all my idea.
But you didn't know.
I just wanted a clean break from here.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. You're the detective. You think of something. I'll be waiting out at the old fishing cannery the next 2 nights, just past the abandoned railway station to Rowley. When you find him, give him this. He'll know it's from me.
So what are you doing? There's a weird... I'm handing you something animation. Alright, is there something with a date on it? Steps. Do I need to be concerned about that? No. I don't know. These are all single digit. How do I cancel out of this? I can't even get in my inventory.
I must have made a mistake.
You think? Month, day, and year. 4-number combination, okay. Again, I went back and replayed that part, and her birthday was yesterday, not last year, or a year off. So it's 2612. I would make a terrible detective, apparently. So, starting clockwise, 2, 6, 1, 2. There we go.
Yes, that's it. The safe holds a heavily bound manuscript. The front is embossed with the words, Book of Dagon.
to interact with it. Alright. Let's be bold and go out the front door.
It won't open.
Or not.
It's getting late. I'd better find some place to check in for the night.
Yep. Something tells me I'm not gonna wake up in my room in the morning.
I should leave him alone. He's in no mood for talking. It seems the bus has been delayed till morning.
Is it, sir? That's an awful shame.
Do you have board for the night?
We've plenty on the top floor of the house. Nice views over the town, I'm told.
Great. That sounds just swell.
There, sir? Starting to look kind of funny there for a while. Face as white as bone and eyes as black as coal. Like you'd seen a ghost or something.
I'm fine, thanks. It's just the sea air around these parts. It makes me queasy.
The Innsmouth's breeze is not for your outsiders.
Charlotte. Can you come with me? I need to be telling you something. Perfectly.
Excuse me, sir. The Innsmouth Law doesn't like to be kept hanging about. I'll be right back with you shortly.
That sounds suspicious. Is he gonna die?
It's the key to the back office. It's unlocked.
What am I looking for?
The rug is caked in dried up blood and guts.
Yep, let's open the door instead of staring at the rug. Shotgun shells. I'd like to go get a gun to go with all these bullets.
There are severed body parts strewn all over the office. I wonder what secrets this book... The hatchet is encrusted with blood. I'm not touching it. There are severed body parts strewn all over the office.
Just follow me, sir. I'll show you to your lodgings. I heard there was a killing over the old Waits house tonight. They reckon the old fool killed his own daughter. Caked head to toe in her blood, they says. And had to be dragged away, screaming and crying. I reckon there'll be a lynching for what he done.
Am I gonna say anything about that? Not gonna, like, defend him?
Still looking pallid, sir. You're needing to have yourself some rest. Sleep well, and keep down the racket. Us Innsmouth are quiet folk.
Okay. Uh-huh. unlock this? Yes. Alright. Some smokes.
Mighty nice. Nothing of interest.
She were a lively one, and no mistake, I kept her going as long as I could, and for the music she were making, such a pair of lungs, and after she were done, I found those lungs on her look as good as they sounded. Maybe I'll keep them. Her liver was particular sweet as well. Ugh, cannibals. I never much wanted to go to New York, but if they all talk as much as this one, I reckon I ain't missing much. Soon as he woke and saw the knives, he was away, talking and pleading and bargaining for his life. All them words made me dizzy, and I had to take his tongue first to stop him. In future, I better wait a while after they'd eaten dinner, for his innards stink awful. Nice. The bones was nearly all out before he died. I was real careful around the arteries, so as he didn't lose any more blood than can be helped. And he lasted a lot longer for it. The flesh moved on its own as he tried to work his arm, but with the bones gone, there weren't nothing it could do, just twitch. I took it out, the strap, so it could move free, and I watched. The new gag worked much better as he was more quiet than the last. Lovely. Serial killer, eh?
It's late. I don't think it'd be wise to wake the other guests.
So I'm not supposed to move that. Okay.
An old wardrobe. Better. Not exactly safe, but the best I'm gonna get in this infernal town.
At least I locked the doors. Maybe it's for the best I left that one blocked. Early evening, Innsmouth turned out to be more dilapidated, depressed, and unwelcoming than initially expected. The stench of rotten fish fills the air, while poverty and disease lie festering in every cobbled back street. Only a few of the inhabitants have been at all cooperative. The others are evasive and sometimes downright hostile. Pages. Okay. I'm not gonna read through all of this here. That would take a while. So you all can pause and read to your heart's content. I'm just scanning through for obvious clues. Dreams.
The great city of Nakotas. Rest now, Jack. You are safe. What was in the light, Jack? Where do you want to go? We are your history, Jack. and your future.
I don't understand.
You live in time.
Human, where have you put the outsider?
Top of the house.
I didn't put the key back.
Come on, let's have it.
I bolted all the doors to the room. Supposed to do. What am I doing?
Curtis.
What am I gonna do?
It's locked. Probably bolted on the other side. He's awake in there. I can hear him moving about.
Hide in a
break the door down.
Come on.
The door's bolted shut.
Hurry up.
Quick. I see him head
This is taking too long. I've got to slow it down first.
There's a bolt on that door.
All right. A fighter.
Dang it.
Stop.
Frig. Come on.
Hold it. Bring him down.
Damn it! Stop!
Open. Stop!
Alright, I'm dead. I know.
Stop!
I see the
door. Get away!
Check the door.
Let me through! The door won't be bolted. Outside! Get away!
Damn it! Why?
The lock of the store is broken.
Stop!
I'll have to block the door with something, and quickly.
Stranger, stop!
This is taking too long. I've got to slow them down first.
No, they're already in here. I can't slow them down.
Come here, outsider!
Gotta press on.
He's climbing out the window. He's on the other side. Shoot him! Here we go. A fighter. Stop. Take him down. Get him. He's up there. After him.
Oh, I'm going too slow.
got him! He's climbing out the back! He's up there!
Outsider! After him!
I'm out of time for this right now, guys. When we resume, I'll just pick up that me successfully getting through that. Thanks for coming back and watching part 3. Of course, as soon as I say something about it not being very action-y, it gets action-y. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe, tell your friends, and I will see you all in the next episode. Till then, later.